Ladies and gentlemen, live from our London studios, Ronnie Irani's big question of the day.
Go on, chicken.
Just a quick one from me, Tony. Obviously, you've man-managed individuals, and listen, Mark Hughes is his own man. He's a tough character, we know that. And, you know, with the fans calling for Harry Redknapp, you know, that's a difficult one to swallow when you're trying to lead your side, isn't it?
Sorry, I didn't understand the question.
Right, let's get the financial news. Bob Diamond getting pelters from the banks and the papers today. Let's say a very good morning down to Canary Wharf and BGC's David Buick. Morning, David.
Morning, David.
Good morning, gentlemen. So, the other interesting thing, Ronnie, just before it goes, I know, is that what really shocked me on Monday is that European Union debt is now regarded below emerging markets. How about that?
Wow. Is that right?
Yeah.
Oof, good effort, that.
That's not good news.
It's time for this.
Crisis? What crisis?
Were you not an Olympic swimmer?
Just because you rode a horse now and again, so what?
Gavin Hastings, what is his actual first name?
Go on, chicken!
I believe in life. I don't know about you, Mike. I know you didn't have any mentors. But your first loss is your best loss. Your first loss is your best loss. You know, a wise guy told me that, who's from the north, and he lives in the south now, very successful man, done all right for himself, but he always said to me, he says, Ronnie, and he's told it me recently as well, he's a good man, he said, Ronnie, your first loss is your best loss. And, you know, if Dalglish is big enough and brave enough, which I believe he is, and he doesn't think that Andy Carroll is right for him, then take it on the chin, get some money in, and move on. Your first loss is your best loss. Because, you know, the big goal for Liverpool is to be competing for the Premier League and Champions League. You know, the big trophies are a massive club, huge fan base, great history, and they've got a bit of financial clout too. Now, if Andy Carroll, they're going to lose the best part of, you know, £20 million on him, or a little bit more, whatever the figure is, then fine. Your first loss is your best loss. You know, take the loss and move forward. Don't just sort of sit there and let it be costing you when it comes to results. If he's not the player that suits you and your team, you have to move them on. Your first loss is your best loss. And it'd be no embarrassment at all. Not at all. I think he'd be a brave man to do it and an exceptional manager if he feels as though he's not going to win Liverpool any trophies. Your first loss is your best loss.
Got a couple of them for you. The first one. What I'm going to do with this... Just going to let it speak for itself. So, Ronnie, take it away.
Has anybody been sort of so inspirational from the heavens above, Al, like Seviano Ballesteros has for the Ryder Cup? Has been anybody sort of like that? I can't think of anyone right now who's been sort of so inspiring from above, especially for a team.
Alan on the M6, he says,
hey, guys, the best. Because we've got another one from this morning, and this is with regard to Celtic.
If you had your last pound yesterday and you said you had to have a bet, forget your allegiances, but either, you know, Celtic or Spartak Moscow, what would you get on?
What you mean on the game last night or the game at Parkhead?
No, the game last night.
I was hoping for a draw, to be honest.
No, your last pound, what would you done?
Well, I was hoping for a draw.
So you'd gone for the draw, would you?
Yeah,
you would have gone for the Moscow win.
Sometimes you want to ask the same question. He's unbelievable.
Your first loss is your best loss.
Anytime, any place, anywhere.
It's mistimed, it's alright.
It wasn't reckless. It wasn't
but it's alright if you mistime it, that's alright, it's a forgiven.
It's a booking, but you know, it's nothing else. I don't think that is not in the same category as Essien, Catamol and Jerome Thomas. Elsewhere last night, Joey Barton, I was beginning to like him. I've spoken to him a couple of times this year, heard him do a long interview with Stan. I'm thinking, you know what? All I've heard in the past about Joey Barton is wrong, and then last night he does his Muhammad Ali impression.
To be fair, Ronnie...
did you see why he did it?
Ronnie has spotted the
I'm not saying it's right, but do you know what he did?
Yeah, I know he did.
You know what happened before?
Yes, I saw what happened before.
What happened
he
before?
He dropped his shoulder.
caught him big time.
But there's no provocation. If what about this?
Not right what Joey Barton's
done. If I walk past you and give you a bit of a shove, yeah. Does that mean at 7 o'clock in the while phasing in the booth, you're going to come out, go, hello, Moose, and smack me
if
in the
if you drop the shoulder on me,
yeah,
I'll do the same
right,
to you.
At 7 o'clock, I'm going to do that and see what your reaction
is. Go for it. Anytime, do it anytime you want, mate.
And I'll let people know.
You drop the shoulder on me, and then see what you get.
It's a superb possibility, isn't it?
No excuse,
I'm not saying it's an excuse, but if somebody drops a shoulder on your face, you can cause some serious damage on them, I'm telling you now.
I could provoke you all I like this morning, and Danny, it doesn't give you the right to hit me.
No, I'm not saying it did, I'm not saying it's right, but it's not right to you to drop the shoulder on me, Moose, because that's violence as it is.
Finally, the
you're not going to go at the guy who committed, you know, violent crime to start with.
Finally, the Manchester Derby last night of Essex. You heard the trail, by the way, where he claims that he's
best at
teaching cricket, is the best at broadcasting.
Listen, Alistair wouldn't have been anywhere without chicken.
I know.
How'd you work that out?
We're performers. We're performers. Listen and just smile and enjoy.
Alistair,
that's
also,
all about. That's why we do this gig.
Chicken has got the freedom of London City. Aye, and
yes.
So has Alistair.
Well, that's what I was coming on to.
They can both drive cheap.
How did you get the freedom of
over Tower Bridge?
I passed his name on.
How did you get the freedom of City in London?
Do you know how much money I've done well for charity over my career?
Oh, I see. So you don't give money
my
for charity.
My cricket career.
So you don't give money for charity out of the goodness of your heart. You did it, so at the end of the day you can get...
Yeah. No. They awarded me because of what I'd done previous, numpty. So have a little think about that. Just be very careful.
Don't frighten me, Ronnie. You don't
my cricket
me.
Career, 20 years. Yeah. Caps in Essex.
Three caps, yeah.
Doing well. 32 on the internationals. 20,000 runs. Three tests. Your first loss is your best loss.
And what's just one final one, Stan. We're doing our Twitter-only poll. Hashtag breakfast pleb. So who gets your vote on the Twitter poll?
I'm breakfast. What do you mean, breakfast pleb?
What do you think?
who's the breakfast pleb?
Yes.
Ronnie.
Oh, it's got to be the Moose, isn't it? Actually, the...
No, Moose is a legend.
That's kind of breaking news to me, I tell you.
Ronnie.
Okay, Stan, we'll leave it there. Thank you very much.
If a third don't like you, a third are not bothered, and a third do like you. You're two-thirds of the way, so happy days.
I do that. What are you doing at the weekend?
Well, I'm doing a school presentation for Smithers School, my school up north, at Bolton, Victoria. Big place.
Any chance you've done something for your kids, because you're never at home these days?
What are you talking about? I'm always at home. Was it the
weekend? You're all over the place.
No, I was at the weekend at home.
Kirby Longsdale last weekend.
I do plenty for my kids, Alan. So, sometimes you've got to put out, and last time I did a presentation of this sort for my school, Smithers School.
I told you that your kids have to listen on radio before, you know, with Dad.
Not at all. Amir Khan, I presented, there was a young Asian lad come up to the stage.
Yeah.
And a guy I went to school with, who's head of P, you know, Jason Nash and Gary Dickinson, they both come up to me and said, see this lad here? I said, yeah, I'm here. He's called. I said, all right. He's going to be a world champion. I went, give us a break, will you? Hey, come on. What? Little Rocky? Look at him. What, little Rocky? Come on. Like that. I said, yeah, he's going to be a star. I said, well, all right, what was he saying? He's going to the Olympics very soon. I said, is he? He says, yeah, and there you go, Amir Khan, the rest is history. I presented his award.
I see you got more famous school than mine.
Maybe.
Morning, Jim. Morning, Charlie.
I've seen him box when he was 14 down at the
Grove. Oh, hello. He's not just MUTV picking football stars.
I've seen him
now
box.
He's picking young future world champion
when
boxers.
He was 14, and I went up to him, and he lost that fight. And his dad came up to me, who's a big cricket man, and I had a good chat with him. And I said, oh, by the way,
stick with it. Boxing.
I said, stick with it. I said, you're going to be all right. Look, you're fast. You've got rapid combination. You know, you're 14. Stick with it. I mean, you're going to be a real champ. I believe in you. I believe in you. I felt like Louis Walsh. I believe in you.
Oh, don't start me.
And he looked at me and he went, he just nodded because he was very disappointed. And his dad went, oh, thanks. Means a lot to him. You never know. Those words could come true.
What's his name
so
again?
I inspired him. Amir Khan. World champion.
Oh,
that was it. It was Amir Khan.
Oh, Ronnie, get lost.
Alan,
Ronnie,
it was Amir Khan.
I've been to prize giving with you. You tell that to everyone.
Alan.
It's a numbers game. You tell 2,000 people one might be an ABA
Alan,
champion.
I swear now, Amir Khan it was. It was 14. I saw him 2 years later presenting at my school. I did a presentation to him. Sporting Endeavour, he was brilliant. They come up to me, he's going to be a star. And I went, don't worry. I spotted him 2 years ago. You guys are a little bit late here at the old,
Was that on MUTV?
No, it's a beauty. I'm telling you, that's what happened.
Did he have positivity in those days?
I'm good at identifying talent. I can spot it a mile off.
Your first loss is your best loss. In the city.
8:42, Hank, good morning. Good
morning, chaps.
You okay, mate? Did you see the football last night? Did you get a chance?
Did see a little bit of the footballs at the RSE, and they had the big game on there. Looked pretty good, I have to say.
Was so it the old Reddies down there, pay for the wedding?
Not exactly that, Mr. Brazil. No, but it was all very fine, and nice to see it's going to go to the second
We've had an email from Akatols.
From who?
Akatols, it says. It Chris Akatols, your best man?
A.K.A., I think that means.
Oh, Bruce.
I mean, you're not the best, are you?
Walker's Crisps, stop Walker's. Is that a laugh as well? Walker's Crisps.
I think it's Walker's Crisps.
Hey, what about the old family?
Leather goods and fashion division, which accounts for a third of revenue, grew by 12%.
Chicken's got the whole, he's got the whole Louis Vuitton the range, all the bags. I think it was Fuenger all the beach, wasn't
no,
it?
No, never.
In 1997.
I've never had one in my life. I'm more of an Armani man, to be honest, though.
I could see you going round with one of those big trunks, Ronnie.
No, not that I've one, to be honest. I'm still with the old England tour bags and Pelty, I think.
Do you get one of those?
Yeah. Hank, I want to ask you about black...
Did Goffy give you one?
Yeah, no, he's got three. One. No, give him a break, Hank. He's got three bags.
Have you, Hank? Have you got any?
What?
Did Barclays give you any issue?
We've got the full Barclays range, thank you very much. It looks like Barclays now is here, I tell you, with every aspect of the range.
I should have BlackRock boosted by Leapman Exchange traded funds. Incredible, that's when investors pour money into exchange traded funds at BlackRock. But we better not, Hank, because I know you maybe not got that on your screen. And then Sony to get green light for...
All right, Ronnie.
And then Sony to get green light for EMI deal. What about
that? I didn't
know
you could read things off your screen, to be fair. I mean, it's not one of your greatest assets, to be fair, is it?
It's a good day for Ronnie Irani. His autobiography, No Boundaries, has been voted Sports Book of the Month. But the race is now on to be the voice of the audiobook. A number of top names from the world of sport and showbiz have been auditioning for the job. We can hear some of them now reading from Ronnie's book. First up, Zippy from Rainbow.
When Darren Goff wants to come dancing, I bought everyone champagne. Yeah, it was the least I could do. I just cleaned up at the bookies with odds of 25-1.
Oh, terrible.
Our very own Jack Bannister's also read an extract.
Oh, God, here we go.
Well, different viewpoints are what makes speech radio interesting. But of course, you get the odd numpty who just wants to be abusive, such as the guy you phoned in to complain when I criticised Chelsea after they knocked out the Champions League by Barcelona. He said, "Hey, Ronnie, I'm sick of you criticising Chelsea." "Okay, pal, but my name is Ronnie." "Look, Irani." And he launched into a tirade. I tried to persuade him to have a proper discussion, but he wouldn't have it the same way that I couldn't have a proper discussion with MJK Smith after the argument at Chesterley Street in 1972. So I faded him down and said, "For the last time, my name is Ronnie Irani."
And finally...
Jack was from Birmingham. Brilliant.
Finally, not one to miss out the man who wrote the book, Ronnie Irani, has had a go.
Well, you know, Alan Brazil and I, you know, we hit it off straight away, you know, boom, straight in there, classic. And the chemistry started to come across in the programmes, you know, pace, brilliant, funny, you know, moves. We talked to each other as though we were back in the dressing room, you know, laughing, you know, teasing, joking, forums, you know. What do you think about that, Al? But also talking frankly, you know, about the issues.
As brilliant. Yet, we have yet to receive word of who's going to get the gig.
Mr. Dancer, wonderful. Yeah, thanks for that. Sportsbookofthemonth.com. Peter Sharkey, very kind of you. And hopefully, Al, you read it yet?
I've got a long flight to New York coming up.
Yeah, well, we'll see. Get on there. No, good stuff. Fun and games. Thanks for all your support as well. It's been amazing.
Shot, mate.
Quite humbling as well.
Nice
for me,
one.
Which is a little bit strange. But...
Alan Brazil's Breakfast Bank Book. Big fun and finance with Pulp Sport's compulsive banker, Hank Potts.
Who's that, Big Egg?
I know. Something just stuck in my throat there. You touch the high road,
and I'll touch the low. We'll be in Scotland before Ronnie, because Ronnie's not coming. Ronnie's not coming.
No, I've got book signing, Hank. Sorry, I can't make it.
Oh, Hank, I can't
listen,
wait.
I wouldn't take too
wait.
Many pens if I were you, Ronnie.
Weekend Mr. Potts has had. Hank, good morning.
Hey, morning, chaps. Very nice weekend, thank you very much. Bought myself a new Apple computer, so that took a little time getting used to it.
Good bonuses, eh?
What's the golf? That was terrific.
Donald, brilliant.
Yeah, fantastic. I like the match play format, actually, very pleasant. So enjoy that bit of rugby I watched. So very relaxing indeed, and then the Oscars, of course. I suppose you wanted King's Speech to win, Ronnie.
Listen, I was just happy with it. Is it Natalie Portman? Black Swan? Fantastic.
Well, I just thought, given the problems you've had with your reading and so forth, King's Speech...
You've got to be a stutter a lot easier.
Well, yeah, you're stutter, Hank, and also your bonuses, and everybody hates you. And I don't know, what's it matter? Who cares? You've got to move on.
Don't bite, don't.
Good morning, Hank. How are you?
Morning, Station of the Year.
Oh, you're part of it, today. Yeah, of course you are.
I'm part of it. I'm most of it. What are you talking about? Most of it.
Well, only a little bit, about 3.5 minutes worth of it.
Well, you know, probably about half of what you've contributed, but there we go. We've all got our role to play. Long weekend and, of course, the Royal Weekend. Weekend, wedding.
Take your time, you're doing well.
Retail sales jumped.
The awards in the post.
I've learned from the best, Ronnie. I've learned from the best.
Keep coming.
Who was that teacher you went to?
Keep going.
Well, I tell you, some figures, Hank, you're doing something right, mate. Record figures again for TalkSport for the last 3 months.
Well, I'd expect nothing less. We've got a dynamic team, of course, with myself, you, Mr. Brazil, and we're able to keep Ronnie above water as well. So, it just shows you, even with the pressures that we face out, even with the handicaps of those around us, we're able to go ever higher. And we
Metallica, you know, who listens to that sort of music?
Oh, the massive.
What?
They're so successful.
You've either got to have long hair or shaving hair with a couple of earrings and all that, and tattoos everywhere. No, it's not for me.
Maybe in their private jet, I'll or two.
Do you know any of their songs, Ronnie?
Oh, huge they are.
Which
absolutely
is your favourite?
Huge.
I'll come back to you on that.
Enter Sandro, I think.
What?
Is it Enter Sandro? It's a good one.
Ed, shut up.
Go on, one more, Ronnie.
What, Metallica?
Yeah.
Oh, there's loads of them out there.
Are there?
They're so successful, they're huge.
Well, you'll be looking forward to their tour. They're playing next year now, bringing it forward, to playing the major rock festivals. Very indeed, getting the stag do together, getting the roles sorted out for the wedding. I was asking Al whether I thought you'd do a reading for us, Ronnie. He said that probably wouldn't be wise. I don't know why.
I'm too expensive for you.
He says you may need a few lessons before
that's
the wedding.
Harsh. Why? Whoa,
that's massive deflection. Have you heard our reading later?
Oh dear.
Shouldn't it be embarrassing someone running their little finger along the words as they're reading in the church?
Yeah, that is a huge deflection. Massive.
Here's Rupert.
Rupert, Rupert the Bell. Everyone sing his name. Rupert, Rupert the Bell. Everyone come and join.
Rupert Bell on Talk Sport.
Oh, it's lovely to hear that your announcement again, Rupert.
Thank you, Mark. You're rubbing it in, aren't you?
Well, Ruby was demanded that we played that this morning.
Oh, very good. Thank you very much.
And
good
what
old
a day
Ruby.
For Ruby yesterday. Oh. Especially dropping the whip, the stick. I mean, hands and heels. Brilliant.
How good was that? That was fantastic. We had the match between those two, Grand Cru. What were you wanted? He eyeballed Grand Cru and said, you aren't getting past me, and he stormed up the hill. And the reception here at Cheltenham for Ruby Walsh and Big Bucks as they came down that avenue in front of the packed grandstands, then into the winner's enclosure, was as good as I've seen it at Cheltenham. Three cheers ringing out round the winner's enclosure as well for Big Bucks. Fantastic.
Another reason why we should ban the whip, Rupert?
Oh, no.
Come on.
Ronnie, you've never been near a horse in your life.
Sorry, I've owned about three horses. No, what about Sags?
No.
You speak to Pat Eddery, and he'll tell you he never marked a horse in his life. The best jockeys, hands and heels, all day long.
No, you need... if you use the whip, and they've made...
Don't talk to him about it, Rupert.
Ronnie,
let's talk about the golf cart.
Yeah, absolutely.
He just doesn't know what he's talking about.
No. I think I might do, Mark. I'm more qualified than you. Just because you rode a horse now and again, so what?
And yes, and I've got a brother who's a trainer.
No, Rupert's fine. I'm on about Sagas here, giving it large.
Well, Mark's ridden plenty of horses this time.
What a champion he is.
So. Oh, Ronnie, just Ronnie, don't spoil the end of the week, mate. Yeah. Let's talk about the Gold Cup. Let's talk about some sensible stuff. Come on, Rupert. It's the conditions down there. That rain never really came.
No, it hasn't come at all. There was a little bit of rain around Cheltenham last night, but there's nothing to speak of. And this morning they're expecting 1 to 2 millimetres. It's overcast, but no rain. Good ground. There was talk that possibly Pandorama might come out of it because of no rain. Well, I think I've just heard that the connections are prepared to take their chance. The ground is good, so that means that the Mud Lovers, it might be against Denman, who definitely needs a bit of juice in the ground, but it might help Corto Star. So, you know, you pays your money and he takes your choice. I've never known as open a Gold Cup as this, and I think the odds reflect it, and everyone talking around here just can't make their mind up about the race.
It's tough, isn't it?
It is so tough. I mean, there are statistics being bandied around. Last 11-year-olds to win, 1962. You know, history's against Corto Star and Denman, potentially. You know, 10-year-olds don't win many Gold Cups either. So is that against Imperial Commander? There's so many statistics being bandied around and horses being tipped up all over the place in what looks a great race. Sadly, I don't think What a Friend is going to be one of them. So, Sir Alex Ferguson, I think it's...
Okay, right, well, let's just forget
you
about
carry
it.
On, Sykes.
Okay, let's just
you know your stuff.
Ronnie,
carry on, Sykes.
Grow up. I'll speak to you, Rupert, because let's get some sense into it.
Your first loss is your best loss.
I think you watched the final, didn't you? Brazil-Mexico.
Yeah.
That was a shock to me. I thought Brazil's were going to be a shoo-in.
Well, they've obviously got some stunning players who will go on and be, you know, global stars, certainly in Europe and in the Premier League. So, yeah, it was a shock. But Mexico, just a bit more fight about them, Al. Maybe the Azteca in them, you know. It was just one of them where they...
The what? The Azteca?
Yeah, you know, the warrior. The warrior in them. You know the Azteca Stadium, don't you? And the warrior in them.
Let's go back to, you know...
Exactly. The warrior in the blood. And maybe they had that. That's what I saw a little bit more than Brazil. Brazil had the flair and, you know, wonderful style. But even so, it was a turn-up for the books. What else was I going to mention there about England?
We were going to mention the business, weren't we?
Yeah.
Here comes Hank.
Alan Brazil's Breakfast Bank Book. Big fun and finance with Talk Sport's compulsive banker, Hank Potts.
In the city.
Azteca?
Morning,
Hank. How are we?
Hey, morning, boys. I'm sure Ronnie's very familiar with the Aztec people.
Yeah? How's your history going, all right?
Well, probably better than yours, Ronnie.
Go on, then. Tell me about them.
What, the Aztec people?
Yeah.
Well, ethnic groups of central Mexico, particularly those groups that...
Strong warriors, weren't they?
Very good. Which era were they from? Remind me of the century?
I don't know, but obviously you know.
14th to 16th century, I'd say, Ronnie.
And they were strong warriors, fighters, winners.
Well, you said that a couple of times
and
already.
Were they or
so,
not?
What?
Were they or not?
They were indeed.
Just
Ronnie,
like their football team the other day against Brazil.
Yes, I think that's wonderful.
This one's, of course, Monty and Paul Laurie.
Oh, very good.
Hank, listen, so this is your last day for a while.
Just the last day.
You're tying the knot at long last, and you're heading off down to somewhere in the States. Very nice.
West coast of the US, beautiful down there. So very much looking forward to it, looking forward to seeing you guys on Friday, and let's hope the weather's nice. The band plays up, the drinks will be flowing, that is for sure, and the canapes will be lovely.
Lovely. You become an Azteca god that day, eh?
I would leave that if I was you, Ronnie. You struggled for a love to love.
Yeah, right. Tell you what, he must have been down the library yesterday. You sure you were at the Grove, not the library?
You weren't at the Grove again yesterday, were you?
Yeah. I don't know.
They must be getting sick of the sight of you, aren't they?
Well, it's not cheap.
Packing up their course.
It's good. It's a great condition.
You get a little freebie and all of a sudden, but taking advantage of it. Oh, dear, oh dear.
I wish.
You invite him once, suddenly you've got a best friend for life.
And that's been offsetting the slump in spending that I've been seeing in Italy and in Spain.
Hank, when you're out and about, are you a Kindle man?
No, I'm an iPad man, I have to say. Nothing better than the iPad. Absolutely brilliant.
Reading books and stuff. And by the way, Goffey's been on. He said, any chance of an invite to the stag do?
Well, it'd be nice to have a cricketer there that's, you know, a winner. It'd be fantastic to have a character on the tour.
I was toting my pack along the dusty Winnemucca Road when along came a semi with a high-end canvas-covered load. If you're going to Winnemucca Mac with me, you can ride. And so I climbed into the cab and then I settled down inside. He asked me if I'd seen a road with so much dust and sand, and I said, listen, I've traveled every road in this here land. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Crossed the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere.
Seen some weird things, horrible things, tackles, you know, people come lunging in front of me. I was at the game when Haaland and Roy came up. That was right in front of me where I was, and you know, the United fans in front of me, we just sat there with the mouth open. We couldn't believe what we'd seen.
Ronnie, I repeat this with your permission, by the way. You're in the newspapers today.
Oh, no, it's a classic.
Where were you on April the 21st, 2001, the day Roy Keane ended Alfie Inge Haaland's career with an appalling challenge in the Old Trafford derby? This is in the Daily Mirror. TalkSport's Ronnie Irani last week told listeners, I was at the game and the incident took place right where I was sitting. United fans were sitting with their jaws open. They couldn't believe what was happening, which is all very curious because actually... You were scoring 87 for Leicestershire.
Not for Essex.
For Essex. Yeah. And you got a wicket. And you got a wicket as well. So, just an honest mistake?
Yeah, what happened was, we were talking about, you know, the weirdest thing you've seen at a football ground. And I was relating to, remember Roy Keane and Yap Stam sort of coming over to refereeing? For the life of me, I thought that was the same game. And we're all aghast thinking, what have they done here? And it's funny, I was leaving TalkSport that morning. My dad said to me, you weren't to that game. And I said, yeah, I was. I remember. I said, he said, no, you wasn't. And I said, just whatever, mistake, just leave it. And then the keyboard warriors started that afternoon, and I've left it all week because I've been laughing at them. They just give you absolute pelters, don't they, on the social networking.
I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Mattawa, La Paloma, Bangor, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Tocopilla, Barranquilla, and Padilla. I'm a killer. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts, bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. Travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere.